Hi, it's Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do the daily vibes for around the second, but we all know that the timing is fluid, right? So let's just see what comes up. What do we have for, well, whenever it resonates. Page of Cups reverse. So Page of Cups reverse. That is maybe a rejection of some sort. Or, I don't know, could be sad news. Ten of Rods. So Ten of Wands. We have somebody here that is overwhelmed. Could be in a one-sided situation. Looks like somebody is... This is too much. This is too much. I mean, obviously, this is way, way, way too much. It's overwhelming. So we do have somebody here that is overwhelmed. You know? And there could be some tears that are shed. You know, maybe somebody's gotten their bubble burst. Something, you know, isn't growing the way that it should. Oh my God, I can't believe this is happening. This is too much. I can't take it. That's what I get. I can't take it. Nine of Pentacles reverse. So here we go again. Nine of Pentacles reverse. That is no grace, insecurity. Can't take care of themselves. I feel like we have a very needy individual here, you know, with the Nine of Pentacles reverse right next to the Page of Cups reverse. Emotionally insecure. Somebody is emotionally insecure. There's a lack of value here. Somebody may not know their value or not really happy anyway. Somebody's not enjoying their life. They're not happy. This is too much. It's too much. Overwhelming. Somebody's probably in a one-sided situation where there's no reciprocation and they're overwhelmed with all the responsibilities or all of the burden. Somebody's carrying a heavy burden as well with that Ten of Wands. Definitely struggling. Action is needed. Somebody needs to take action. But they're not listening to their intuition. Somebody's intuition is talking to them, but they're not listening. They're not listening. It's like, you gotta get up. You gotta get out of there. You know, you gotta do it. Just do it. Just leave it all behind. This is too much. We could also have a drama queen here. You know, a drama queen that is overdoing it, you know. A lot of tears, you know, shedding tears, you know, poor, poor, pitiful me. Seven of Wands reversed. Stiff competition, big competition, a lot of fighting going on, a lot of fighting. It's too much. This is definitely, there's just too much fighting going on, a need or a desire to compete. There's a need to surrender and walk away, but somebody's definitely having a hard time walking away from a fight, from a challenge. But this person is worn down. They are really worn down. And I feel like they're losing their... they're losing their ability to master their emotions, for one. You know, I feel like there's having a hard time controlling their emotions, and therefore, and there could be some anger. Somebody could blow up because this is too much. There could be a blow up. There could be a big, huge fight. Just saying. I feel like somebody wants to be independent. They want to be independent, but, or maybe they don't. It could go either way. Not feeling loved. Somebody's not being loved. They're in a one-sided situation and there's a lot of freaking fighting. There's a lot of competition. Somebody may be at the point where they're ready to admit defeat. This is like admitting defeat. This is way overwhelming. So somebody may be at the point where they admit their defeat, you know? It's time to go. It is time to go. It's time to go to a better place. This has been very troublesome. Somebody has been staying put, allowing themselves to be demanded. It's like, you do this, you do that, you know, very under somebody else's control. I feel like somebody's been under somebody else's control. They've allowed it, but it's definitely time to go. I mean, that Six of Swords is it's time to go. It's time to move on. It's time to go to a better place. We have somebody here that has reached the point of, I can't do it anymore. Seriously, I can't do this anymore. It's too rocky. It's too turbulent. There's too many waves. It's too much. So I feel like somebody's going to be taking a journey. They're going to be going someplace, you know? They are, by the looks of things. They're making a decision to go in another direction after reaching the breaking point. I feel like somebody is reaching the breaking point. Getting out. That's just getting out of there. Maybe even being rescued. It feels like, because you notice there's a person here. Somebody could be coming to the rescue, you know. Help could even be arriving, you know. Somebody may call for help, you know. And we definitely have somebody here that is unstable, that is insecure, that plays the pity game, the pity party. You know, this person has a self-image problem. They like to fight. They love to fight because it's a challenge. They want to fight constantly. It's like they jump at the challenge, you know, and whoever they're fighting with has reached the point of, I just can't do this anymore. It's either you just leave or I'm leaving. You know, this is leaving. Somebody's leaving. Getting the hell out of there because I can't. This is so overwhelming. I'm about to have a nervous breakdown. You know, somebody's about to have a nervous breakdown by the looks of things because of all the fighting. So somebody has to leave. So I do feel like somebody's leaving. Fool reversed. Well, that's foolish. Somebody's foolish. They do something without thinking, you know. Pick a fight. You know, this is somebody that is carefree, doesn't care. It's all, you know, fun and games. They think it's funny. It's not funny. Somebody is unprepared. They are unprepared for a departure. They may think it's all fun to fight. They may think, you know, it's fun to bring another person down. And I feel like that's exactly what's happening, you know, because somebody wants to win. They want to win. Very defensive energy, you know. They want to win because it gets to the point where, you know, they have to leave, and then the person that they're walking away from or leaving is totally underprepared for the departure. We have somebody here that ignores advice, okay? This person ignores advice, doesn't listen to anybody. And this person that doesn't listen to anybody is battling their own insecurities. They have insecurities within, which is causing them to fight and basically belittle another person constantly. It stems from their own, maybe it's childhood insecurities, you know, childhood wounds. I don't know. Could go all the way back to the childhood when a reading comes out with the Page of Cups reversed or upright or whatever. Anyhow, there's some sort of insincerity here, or I don't know what it is. Maybe even bullying. But somebody's about to have their bubble burst because whoever they've been fighting with is about to leave by the looks of things. You know, they're about to go someplace. And even if it's for a little while, this is like leaving. Headed towards, going towards a better place. And it could be all of a sudden too. Suddenly, very, very suddenly. This could be like a sudden departure, totally unprepared. We also have an individual that is very naive. That is very naive. They do not realize how stupid they are being. I'm just saying, the Fool reverse is somebody's stupid. You know? Very insecure. Eight of Swords. Oh my God. That is trapped. Mental turmoil. Somebody is really, really struggling. They are struggling with breaking free from something that they are stuck in. They have stayed there because it's comfortable, but it's not. They've been refusing to speak up, pretending that everything is okay when everything is not, choosing not to see, choosing not to say anything, staying in a very tight situation. It's almost like somebody has been bound. They've been tied up. They've been, oh, what's the word for it? Oh God. What is the phrase? It's right there too. It's, you can't do this. You can't do that, but you can, you know what I mean? Owned, you know, but they've allowed it. They've allowed somebody to make all their decisions. They've chosen to give their power away. Somebody has chosen to give their power away to another person, choosing not to see, you know. Somebody has been choosing not to see that they could break free. Not saying anything, allowing. But I really feel like there's some sort of, I don't know, maybe it's help. Maybe somebody's getting help, or help arrives, or something like that. Or somebody starts to see, they start to see that they need to break free. There's a sword right here. Somebody is about to break free. You notice that that's what's going to happen. Somebody is about to break free from a situation that they have been trapped in. They stayed in it for, I don't know, unknown reasons? Because of fear? It is. It's because of fear. It's because of fear and insecurities. Maybe we could have somebody here that is afraid to be alone. Okay, you know, this is about independence. We have somebody here that's afraid to be alone. You know, but they may not be in love with the person they're in love with because the person is controlling, or belittling, or combative, or competitive, or something like that. Anyhow. I do think that there is going to be a breaking free of some sort with these two cards. It's like somebody has reached a very desperate situation by the looks of things. It looks like it's a desperate situation. They desperately need to break free and go, okay? And they need to leave that fear behind. They do. Somebody needs to find their strength. Okay, to break free from this trap that they are trapped in. And it's mental. It's all mental. Fear is mental. It is. Hmm. Two of Rods, Two of Wands. This is a spur of the moment decision. It is. I already knew that it was. It's a spur of the moment decision. It's where you have to choose right now which way you're going to go. You're going to stay put in this desperate situation, or are you going to leave? What road do you want to go down? So somebody's going to come to that, you know, that four way, and they have to choose, you know, which way you're going to go. You're going to go this way, you're going to go that way. What are you going to do? There's multiple options here. There's multiple choices. Somebody's going to be presented with the option, another option, several options. Okay, we have four way here. So there's going to be, it's Two of Wands. Typically, it's only two. But if you look at the arrows, there's four options here. You can stay put, or you can go this way, or this way. What's it going to be? There's multiple options, but somebody is going to be forced, or they're going to be at that road where they get to choose. And this person, whoever this person is very sad. They're very discontent that they have to make this choice. But they do have to make this choice because they're in a desperate situation that is causing them a lot of mental conflict, causing them a lot of mental turmoil. It's keeping them in some sort of troubled situation where they're being belittled, they're being controlled, they're overwhelmed. It's a constant battle, you know? The only way to end the constant battle is to go, obviously, with that Six of Swords, is to make a transition. It's a time of transition. It's a time to take that ride. So yeah, there's going to be a decision that needs to be made. I think somebody's going to be suddenly leaving all of a sudden, and it's because of a fight. Good luck.